course, this Sunday, and the best gift for new dads might be some money advice for the future. The costs with kids can certainly add up, but we know it, even before the birth, as we saw in Father of the Bride Part 2.
The baby slip is finished. Think of it, Bobby. After today, I'm out of your hair.
Did we come out on budget?
Close enough, George. Close enough. Now, close those eyes.
Oh, Frank.
Oh, don't frank me. You never want to have any fun. Close those eyes.
All right.
Drum roll, if you please. Welcome to baby land.
It's beautiful.
Thank you, sir.
I mean it. It's perfect.
And here's the bit. Just don't go nuts. Just try to remember what you feel right at this moment, okay? In fact, do me a favor. Maybe you'll open it after I leave.
Oh, such a good movie. Our five tips for new dads. Please welcome financial planning expert Helen Baker back to the show.
It's nice to see you.
Oh, let's get straight into it. Your first tip is this. Have an emergency fund. Why? Ooh. And how much do you need?
Yes, so how much you need will depend on whether you're trying to make yourself have choices. So do you want to have 3 months, 6 months, 12 months or even longer off from work? And is it for just you or is it for both of you? And then over this side, looking for those things that come from left field. So if you go back to your job and then suddenly you've been made redundant because they've changed things while you've been away or something happens with the roof or the car, and then the extra spending that often happens in there as well.
Okay. You also tell dads to put a new spending plan in action. Does that mean going without dad's favourite things?
Probably a little bit. So it's about you losing that economies of scale of two salaries down to one, and then you've got all these increases. So how much do those nappies cost? And then there's the medicines and swim school and the cappuccinos and pramicize and all of those things. And whilst you might not be doing your fine dining anymore, you're probably dialing in takeaway because you're tired,
yeah,
or people are coming over because of sleep patterns and you're putting more food on. So expenses do generally increase.
Just seeing a spike in contraceptive sales. now, another side of family finance is personal superannuation if you're off work. Tell us about that.
Yeah, so the problem we have is money's not going into superannuation at that time.
Oh, you're right.
So there's opportunities with things called the spouse contribution and another one called the concessional contribution, which both get you some either a tax rebate or the government to match some of that money.
Yep.
But the one I really love now is the catch-up legislation. So it allows you to go back and top up superannuation for years where you didn't maximise that starting from last year. So that's a really great way to push tax-deductible money into your super when you get back to work.
Huh.
Awesome.
Yay, one for the girls.
Yeah.
Now, you say dad should manage their debts for one wage. Should you just add them to the home loan at a lower rate?
So hopefully in your planning you've got rid of all those credit card and personal loans, all those bad debts, so that you just really have the home loan to worry about. If you haven't, then it may be that you should consolidate those with interest rates being really low on the home loan. But trying to get one payment and as low as possible, not increasing those debts is key.
Now, tip number five, you've just brought a new life into the world, but then you have to start thinking about life insurance. So these are pretty serious kind of considerations you need to make. What sort of life insurance do you need? Does it just come with your super or should you be looking at something else?
Yes. So there is often life insurance inside superannuation. It's probably not enough. Right. When you think about, you know, now you've got to look after this child for up to 18 years and also maybe carry the mortgage debt and get rid of that if something happens. So you want to revisit those. And I would say to the grandparents, make sure you check out that your children have done it. Otherwise, if something goes wrong, they'll be looking for physical help from you and financial help.
I actually tried to get life insurance, but when they found out I worked on this show, no one would give it to me.
Do I have to forfeit mine now?
Yeah.
Okay. Potentially, dad's on the second time around with a second partner.
Yeah.
What are the traps?
So that's way common now, isn't it? So when you look, first thing you can look at is your will. Is it going to have you provided for the new spouse and children, or is it going over where it was before and where do you want it to go? The insurances, again, where are they going and are they enough? And then superannuation, who's it nominated to? Is it going to children from previous both? Where do you want it to go? And then we've talked about binding financial agreements again and also sexually transmitted debt. So make sure you protect yourself on all of those aspects.
Oh, wow. It's just what you need when you sleep deprived.
Happy Father's Day, everybody.
Do it early. But it's so important and you have to make sure you're covered and your family's covered. Helen's website is onyourowntwofeet.com.au. Helen Baker, great to see you again.
Thank you.
Now, coming up, the Australian sporting champion with a royal friend.